What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 40 of the Ultimate Let's Play Pokemon Mystery Dungeon Explores the Sky. Last time, we graduated from the guild, and now we are our own independent exploration team. Although, we still have to give 90% of the money we make to the guild, which I think is a load of crap. But it is what it is. There's nothing I can do about it. But anyway, today we're going to be going on our first missions as an independent team. As soon as I clear out some inventory space, some things I do not need anymore, and then I'm going to head to town and get ready. Now, we'll still have to go to the guild to get my jobs, but since now I'm closer to the town instead of the guild, I'll be getting items first beforehand, before I go and see what I can do today. So let's get rid of all the stuff I'm not going to need immediately. Let's see what's up for sale. Yes, we graduated. We're all on our own now. Good, we got a Reviver Seed and a Max Elixir. I'll take the Violent Seed along with it. And now, what do you got? Hopefully some decent orbs or TMs, maybe. You've got... Well, I'll take the Full Hold Orb. That could come in handy if I come across a Monster House. Unfortunately, didn't really have much aside from that. How much money do I have now? I have 3,000. Oh yeah, I got that $10,000 graduation gift. So now I got 13 grand in the bank. Thanks a lot.
Oh, T.U.G. Charmander. Hey, Charmeco! What's going on? Oh, T.U.G. Charmander, congratulations on graduating from the guild. Team Outbound now can stop raising associates with the guild, right? So your assembly privileges also change. Let the bell ring. New special service is available to you. Special service? So what's this special service? Well, it's special. You can now change your leader before your team goes into a dungeon. The team leader? We can change a leader before going into a dungeon? Yes. Up to now, T.U.G was always the team leader in explorations, right? Now because the guild is giving your team affiliate status, you pick a member of Team Earth Mountain leader before going to a dungeon. In other words, you can assemble a dungeon team for only Team Earth Mountain recruits. An exploration team made up that way will still officially be recognized. Oh, I guess that means if we plan to explore a dungeon where our current team will suffer type-based disadvantages, we can build a totally different team, ever changing the team leader, so we can gain type advantages instead. Absolutely. Of course, there are no way to use and Charmander may answer. I'll be making use of my new service. Anyway, good luck with your exploration teamwork.
So yeah, I can now actually take a seat on the bench if I wanted to. But I think I'm going to stick around for the time being. Let's see who I should be bringing for our next mission here. I've got a lot of Pokemon recruits. Unfortunately, not a lot of them are as a decent level, to be honest with you. Again, didn't do a lot of recruiting near the end of my main game there. I'll give Shieldon a chance here. He is a level 27, so he can at least hang with us. Skorupi's always been a ace in the hole, so to speak. Got that pin missile, which I have used a lot. So let's have a look at our missions now. We have some S-rank missions in the Northern Desert. We've also got some A-ranked in the Amp Plains. So before I choose any of those, what do we got over here in terms of the Outlaws? Amp Plains. So if I were to go to Amp Plains, I could get a... three missions done for the price of one here. So I think that's what I'm gonna do. And this should be a relatively quick mission then. Only 7 floors, 3 jobs. But here's what I'm going to do here. I'm going to make Charmander the team leader since I will have a disadvantage against electric types. So gonna get a chance to roll with Charmander a bit here. I'm gonna set my moves. I think I'll leave him as is, to be honest with you. Alright. So Charmander will be taking the helm here as we get ready to head to Amp Plains. These guys have anything to say? Oh, these guys are talking about Zero Isle. That is a dungeon you can only access after you beat the main story, and it's divided into many parts, and it's very long. I think it's like 99 floors. I'm probably not going to be touching that area, though, because I think there's certain restrictions when we got to deal with that. But anyways, Amp Plains is our destination today. We have three jobs on the agenda. Let's make it hot. I'll set Fire Fang as my primary weapon here. Alright, Charmander, lead the way. And Scroop, you just sniped that Ella kid from off the screen. Got a little trigger happy there, if you ask me. So yes, this is our first job as an independent team. You may want to catch up, Scrooby. Come on. Oops, didn't mean to use Fire Fang there. Hit the wrong button. Got TM for Reflect. And there's the stairs heading to the next floor. We got a Mareep and an Elekid right here. Mareep goes down to one Fire Fang. Oh boy. I don't like that low kick against Shield on. He is Rock Steel, so it's got a quadruple weakness to it. Definitely want to get away from that. We got a Plusle, I think that is. Yeah, it's Plusle. Gotcha. And Mareep wants to join us. I'll go ahead and bring Mareep onto the team. I did not want to give it a nickname. And Mareep is going back to the guild. I think Mareep's still at a pretty low level compared to everybody else, so I don't really want to have him around being dead weight, to be honest with you. Okay. Alright, getting very close to our first job here, which is to take down that rogue Grimer. We'll take a Swords Dance TM, glad I didn't spend money on it, got one for free right here. And there's Grimer, let's take him down. One round of attacks was all it took. Alright, one down, two to go. Flamethrower. You have that apple that I want. Not gonna need it right now, but could come in handy later on. At least these Pokemon are going down pretty quickly. We're advancing through this very quickly. We reached destination floor, so we're looking for a missing Pokemon. I think it's Omanyte, if I'm not mistaken. Got a stamina band I have no use for. Another TM, wow. Explosion. But anyway, we found Omanyte. Let's go ahead and rescue him. We'll send him back to the guild. We have one more objective left. I just gotta find the stairs and get it. Take out this giraffe rig here. Missed. Didn't miss the second time. And I came across a dead end. I really hate when that happens. Especially those ones that loop around, you just waste so much time. It's happened to me a couple times already this LP. Can only imagine how many more times it's gonna happen. Got a lot of boxes, gonna give Zatu some work whenever I decide to cash in those boxes that I have. I gotta admit though, the boxes lately haven't been really been yielding a lot of useful items, just hold items for Pokemon that I don't have. Go ahead and take out this Shinx as well. Maybe I can recruit him. Nope. We'll take the Faux Fear Orb. Let's head to the 7th floor. Okay, we're looking for a missing item, if I'm not mistaken. Okay, pick up a couple of Oran Berries here. They're always good to have. You missed me. Looks like we're having lamb chops tonight here. I found the stairs, but I don't really need it. I just tripped and, let's see. We found the grass gummy, so we found our treasure that we were looking for. We're done here. We got through this very quickly. I may end up doing another set of missions at this rate. So we're going for what, only 10, 11 minutes? I think I could do another one. Got a heal seed, we got a Stone Edge TM, and a clear gummy, and 90 points. Got how close we are to leveling up. We'll go ahead and take this Big Apple, 60 more points, and Metapod is going to give us a Reviver Seed. Beautiful, I needed that. And a white gummy on top. And a gold ribbon, wow. This guy is very generous.
We played a full day today. I'm exhausted. We should get some sleep now. We can be resting up for another good day tomorrow.
All right. The next morning, we're not woken up by Loudred.
Good morning, Tate. Let's make another great day.
You know what? Let's go ahead and do that right now. Since I've only been going for a short period, I don't want to have a really short episode. So, let's go ahead and do another mission. I think Charmander did a phenomenal job as the team leader, so I might keep him up front for a little while. We were able to pick up another set of couple of Reviver Seeds, some Oran Berries. We got a lot of good stuff on that one. I may need to do a little bit of reorganizing in my storage. Anyway, what have you got for us here? Let's go ahead and sell this gold ribbon first. Get a quick 2K out of it. And now, well, we've got a Max Elixir, and I'll grab the Stun Seeds as well. Not really what I was hoping to see, but I'll take it at this point. Alright, so now we'll go ahead and make our deposit. Want to keep this money nice and safe in case I need it. I have 15K in the bank now. Alright, so let's head to the guild and see what new jobs await us. Let's look at this side first, change things up here. Monster House, Absol, and Quicksand Cave? I don't know about that. We could go to Foggy Forest, or Mount Horn, or Apple Woods. I'm very iffy on doing that kind of mission. I don't like doing Monster Houses, even if I do have a solid team. New dungeon discovered. I could go to Mystifying Force. It's a 3-star mission. And with Charmander leading the pack, I mean, that'd be a pretty good mission there. So, I could also do Brine Cave. It's going to be a lot shorter. It's only 2-star. But But you know what? What should I do here? And do I want to try this new dungeon discovered? I will have to bring Starly with me. And I don't know where I'm going with this one. I think I'm just going to stick with what I know here. I'm just going to go back to Mystifying Forest, where we had our graduation exam. We're pretty much going to have to go through the whole thing again, 13 floors. But this is going to be worth a lot of points and some decent rewards. And yeah, now we have the Zero Isles available to us. Again, I'm probably not going to explore those unless I absolutely have to, because those are the super dungeons of this game. Alright. So hopefully I can get through this a lot quicker than I did last time. Don't have to deal with the Grandmaster of all things bad. So he says. We know it was Wiggly Tough in the guild. Putting us through one last mission there. I will say though, those guys did put up a heck of a fight. Now we got the fog rolling in. Got an Ivysaur. Good hit with the Skull Bash there. And you just put a shield on to sleep. And me to sleep. Well, and Charmander to sleep. Skorupi, he's the only one that stayed awake. And, he's out of range. He's not going to attack. So I gotta wait for everybody to wake up here, and now we can move on. That guy actually did quite a lot of damage. Had me a bit worried there. Got a sleeping, is that Grodle there? He actually survived Flamethrower. We also got the Skuntank. And he exploded on us. Luckily we were out of range. I was ready for you there. I'll take that Reviver C as well. I just ran to a dead end there. Yeah, note to self, anytime you try and face a Skuntank, stay away from it. Hit it from a distance. Or get a an explosion of toxic gas. Not pleasant. I mean, even the terrain's dying because of that stench. Got another box. So I guess the stairs gonna be up here somewhere. Man. I'd love to have a Bulbasaur on my team, although I don't know what level he's gonna be at here. If I had a Bulbasaur, then we'd have the three original Kanto starters. Well, that remains to be seen if we do end up recruiting a Bulbasaur or not. Again, my ultimate goal is to just complete all the post-game content. There is quite a lot of it in this game, I will say that right now. Ooh, Kecleon Shop. What's this TM? Reflect, it's 6,500 Poké. I have nowhere near that kind of cash on me. Although I may... Do I want that Oranberry? Nah. I can hold off for now. But anyway, like I was saying, there's a lot of post-game content, and it may even go the length of the actual main game, just depending on how fast I can move through it. I don't know how long the videos are going to end up being. I usually shoot for around 20 to 30 minutes an episode. Hence why I'm still going here. Alright, moving on to the next floor. We're moving on to the fifth floor. It's foggy, and I missed this Weeping Bell. Although Skorupi did not miss with that pin missile. Oh, this is not a dead end. It is. Now we're cornered. Come on, I can't afford misses here. I drained a lot of my energy there. I have to be a bit more careful. There's a rest TM here somewhere, and it's being held by Eradicate. I think I've got at least one or two of those, so I'm probably not going to worry about it too much. I'm just going to go ahead and move on. 6-4. We're not quite even at the halfway point here. The first couple of floors went by pretty quickly here, but now we're starting to slow down a bit. Another Ivysaur. Luckily, we're not in fog right now. Good job bringing up the rear Skorupi. I could have sworn this one was going to be a monster house with multiple items in there in a small area. That's usually a dead giveaway. It's going to be a monster house. And luckily, there was not one there. Because then I would have been in big trouble. I'll just go ahead and make my way out of here. The quicker I can get through here, the better. Another Kecleon shop. We got fire stones. We got evolutionary stones here. Unfortunately, I really don't have enough money to buy any of this here. Firestone, Thunderstone. We got a metal coat. And I'm guessing he's standing under what I think maybe one of the other stones there. Didn't bother to have a look at it. Because I don't have the funds to do anything. What's this seed? It's a pure seed. Now we got the clouds rolling in. That'll immediately warp me to a stairway. I'll go ahead and just use it. Alright. More clouds. Now it's wide slash. Now that's a good move for cutting corners, so to speak. I don't know if any of my guys can use it. Maybe Charmander can. We got another shop here? Wow. I think this is the first time I've ever come across three Kecleon shops in the same dungeon. He had more of the evolutionary stones there. Maybe I should have brought some extra money. I could have picked up a couple of those. Maybe evolved a few of my recruits. There's a Torterra around here, so we gotta keep our eyes peeled. I should have enough Fire Fangs and Flamethrowers, though. Where am I at right now? I'm gonna use this just in case. So I know I've been going for a while now. I should be okay for the rest of the dungeon. Then we gotta get to the 13th floor. We're on the 9th. So we're going completely full circle here. This is just gonna link up, so we're gonna have to go into the inner portion of this floor. That's a sunstone. So he's got multiple sunstones there, and a moonstone. I don't know if I have any Pokemon that can use those right now, though. And there's the stairs. I just had to go south from the shop. Yeah, I see you. Oh, it's a Flygon. I hit it, but you survived. Wow, I had to hit it three times with Flamethrower to take it down. And that would be a good Pokemon to have, a Flygon, who is Dragon Ground, although I think I do have a Trap Inch, so I may be able to evolve him. Skuntank. And he didn't explode, thankfully. Alright. Only two more floors to go after this. At least I'm getting some decent pay out of this. I swear, the money I'm picking up on these missions now, they're just completely, I'm making more basically on, I'm calling these tips. I'm making more on tips than I am actually, on like a salary, so to speak. Alright, we got this Flygon to deal with. Let's take it down quickly before it does some damage. We swaggered it. Inventory is full. So we're going to leave that Orenberry behind. I think we've got plenty. Here's the stairs. Alright, so we made it to the destination floor here. Come on, hit him. I don't know if it's just Charmander's accuracy or what, but I don't like when he misses a lot of those attacks. So now he can learn Fire Spin. I'm going to get rid of Dragon Rage. I think Dragon Rage has run its course. So now I've got a third fire attack I can use. And Shieldon got warped to the eastern side of the map. I'm starting to get hungry. But luckily this is the last floor, so I think I should be okay still. Don't need a warp seed. Still gotta find my target here. And as long as Shieldon doesn't do anything stupid, we should be okay. He's taking out a Gulpin. He should be fine there. Quit using Swagger. You've already got him confused. Yeah, we don't need those two. Just use Tackle and Takedown. You've got him confused enough. Good. That's all you had to do there. Didn't have to draw it out there. Well, I found the stairs, but they mean nothing right now. Okay, he's reunited with us, and he found the steel we were looking for. Mission accomplished. Now let's get out of here. Excellent work, Charmander. Did a good job leading the charge here. We're definitely co-leaders now. We'll get a white gummy as a reward. We'll get 400 Explorer Points. Not quite enough yet to level up, though. We're getting there, though. Alright, well, we had 2 days full of missions there, and I think we did a lot of damage here. But I think now it's time to call it quits. I've been going for almost 30 minutes now, so we'll continue with the post-game in the next episode. Until then, this is T.U.G. saying be smart, be safe, have fun. Later, gamers.